بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending the salutations upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam and upon his family, his companions, and upon all those who follow upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day. To proceed, ikhwan. وَسُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلَّمْتَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ Glory belongs to you, Ya Allah. Verily we have no knowledge except that which you have taught us. And indeed you, Ya Allah, you are the all-knower and the all-wise. You are the all-knower and the all-wise. To proceed, ikhwan. وَيَقُولُ الْإِمَامُ أَبُو إِبْرَهِيمُ مُحَمَدِ بْنُ عَبْدِ الْوَهَابِ Al-Abdali Al-Yamani Rahimahullahu Ta'ala Rahimahullahu Ta'ala So the author, our Shaykh, the Imam Al-Allama Abu Ibrahim Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab May Allah have mercy upon him, he continues Qala wa yaqulu Allahu Ta'ala He says, and Allah Ta'ala he mentions Wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِنَا يُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيَّ الْآيَةُ سُورَةُ الْأَعْرَافُ سُورَةُ الْأَعْرَافُ So Allah Ta'ala He mentions And my mercy encompasses all things And I, meaning Allah, shall write it What's the idea of that? Shall write it
My
mercy wasi'at kulla shay encompasses all things and I meaning Allah shall write it alha huna ya'udu ta'udu ila madha what does the it go back to and my mercy encompasses all things and I meaning Allah shall write it alha huna ta'udu ila madha the ha goes back to what The ha. It's aktubu ha. And I shall write it. The ha goes back to what?
Mercy.
The mercy. And I shall write it, meaning the mercy, in a manner that befits His Majesty. For those who have a taqwa, and those that give a zakah. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِنَا يُؤْمِنُونَ And those who they believe in our verses with certainty. Allahu Akbar. They are those who what? They follow the messenger, the prophet. The literate one. سؤال يا إخوان, a question. هل يجوز للعبد أن يصف النبي محمدا عليه الصلاة والسلام بالأمي? Question number one. Is it allowed for a Muslim to say that the Prophet was illiterate? هل هذا يجوز in Islam? Yes. Is that allowed? Yes. To say the Prophet of Allah?
Yes.
No. صحيح. لأن الله تعالى وصفه هكذا. فهذا يدل على أن هذه صفة يجوز للنبي يجوز للنبي So Allah is the one تعالى who described our messenger Muhammad with this description So this shows one of our brothers say Can you raise your voice? Which are our best inshallah That's the last we got طيب فهذه الآية يا إخوان تدل على أنه يجوز للعبد المسلم أن يصف نبينا محمدا عليه الصلاة والسلام بهذه الصفة بهذه الصفة So this verse shows it's allowed for a Muslim to say the Prophet was illiterate ما هو الدليل? What's the proof? عبد الباطن
Allah's proof
أين?
Huh?
Where?
Where?
في هذه الصورة صورة الأعراف as Allah Ta'ala says in صورة الأعراف طيب وقال الله تعالى and Allah Ta'ala he says قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم. سورة آل عمران. And Allah Ta'ala, He says, say to them, O Muhammad, if you truly love Allah, then what? Then follow me. Meaning the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam, yuhbibukum Allahu. If you follow me, Allah will love you and forgive you of your sins. Wallahu ghafurur rahim. And Allah is the all-forgiver and He is the most merciful. Qala shaykhuna al-masna'i hafidhahallah. So our shaykh, the explainer of the words of al-wasabi, he says, الشاهد من هذه الآية إجاب المتابعة. So he says the point here of how the Shaykh is using these verses is to show that following the Sunnah is obligatory. That following the Sunnah is obligatory. قال الإمام السعدي. And the great Imam السعدي used to say, فائدة يا إخوان, a benefit. الإمام عبد الرحمن السعدي هو من مشايخ العثيمين. A benefit. As-Sa'di, he is from the Mashaykh of Al-Uthaymeen. فَتَعَلَّمْنَا الْآنِ إِمَامَيْنِ مِنْ عُلَمَاءِ Al-Uthaymeen. So now we have memorized two scholars from the teachers of Al-Uthaymeen. Al-Awwal, Al-Shaykh Abdul Aziz Ibn Abbas. The first one that we have learned is Ibn Abbas. وَالثَّانِ As-Sa'di. And the second is As-Sa'di. طيب قال السعدي رحمه الله. So السعدي, he mentions, may Allah have mercy upon him, وبهذه الآية يوزن جميع الخلق فعلى حسب حظهم من اتباع الرسول يكون إيمانهم وحبهم لله وما نقص من ذلك نقصا. الله أكبر. قول عظيم وجميل. A beautiful, tremendous statement, يا إخوان. السعدي, he says, so this ayah shows that the creation is going to be weighed. The creation is going to be measured by Allah based upon the portion that they take and which they follow the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, and their iman and their love for Allah. Whatever is deficient therein is deficient. To the end of this tremendous point. قال الإمام المصنعي. So the explainer continues. قال بعد أن ذكر الله تعالى أهل رحمته التي كتب لهم الرحمة بين منهم. He says a tremendous point. He says after we mentioned the verse in Surah Al-A'raf, he says after Allah clarifies and mentions for us who are the people that Allah bestows upon him His mercy. Who are the ones that are from the people of Allah's mercy? Those that Allah has written for them mercy. Allah clarifies for us who are they. وأنهم المتبعون للنبي. He says, and they are those who follow the Prophet. They are those who follow the Prophet. قال ومفهوم الآية. He says, a principle of al-fiqh. The مفهوم الآية. And that which is understood from the verse. ما معنى هذا? What does that mean, يا إخوان? يوجد شيء يسمى المنطوق. There's something with regards to Quran and Hadith that's called the منطوق. المنطوق. That's the actual word. The actual verse verbatim. That's the منطوق. Or you can say لفظي. The actual word for word just as Allah said it. Or كما قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. Or just as the Messenger of Allah said it. ويوجد شيء يسمى المفهوم. And there's something called al-mafhum, what's understood from it. A ماذا يؤخذ منه, ماذا يستفاد منه, meaning what is derived or extracted from it. It may not be the actual word, but it's what's benefited from it. مثلا, an example of that. يقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي من حديث مالك بن حويرث عند البخاري. The Messenger of Allah used to say, and this hadith is narrated by Malik ibn Huwaylith, collected by the Bukhari, he would say, pray the way you see me pray. فَالْمَنْتُوقُ هَذِهِ الْعِبَارَاتِ. So the mantuq is the verbatim way the Prophet said it. صَلُّوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. Pray the way you see me pray. المفهوم ماذا يؤخذ من هذه العبارة؟ That was understood, the مفهوم is what is benefited from it, what is derived from it. فنقول مثلا من هذا الحديث أن يصلى العبد المسلم كما صلى النبي واجب. So we derive from this hadith that praying the way the Prophet prayed is obligatory. The Prophet didn't say pray like me is obligatory or prayer like my prayer is obligatory. He said pray the way you see me pray. But since this is a commandment from the Prophet, sallu, a command, then the scholars, the mafhum was derived from it is to pray how the Prophet prayed is obligatory. Unless there's another hadith to show that this particular thing here, he didn't do it here. Here he did it, here he didn't. So it can't be obligatory. But generally it shows that to pray like the Prophet prayed is obligatory. This is the mafhum. So the Shaykh is saying, what's mafhum from the ayah, what's that which is derived from the verse, is the opposite. أَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَتَبِعُونَهُ لَيْسُ مِنْ أَهْلِ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. If Allah Ta'ala said, is showing that those who are from His mercy are those who follow His Prophet, then the opposite of that is understood. Meaning, those who do not follow His Prophet are not from the mercy of Allah. So there's something called the mantuq, and there's something called the mafhum. The mantuq is the actual word. The mafhum is what's derived. You guys with me, Ikhwan? قال الإمام نسأل الله السلامة. And he says, and we ask Allah for peace. قال الإمام الوصابي وقال الله تعالى. And the author continues, and Allah also says in the same surah, Surah Al-A'raf, قال فآمنوا بالله ورسوله النبي الأمي الذي يؤمن بالله وكلماته واتبعوه لعلكم تهتدون. Allah Ta'ala says, so therefore believe in Allah and in His Messenger, the Prophet, the illiterate one, the one who believes in Allah and in His Word, so follow Him and you will be guided. Ayatun azim, a tremendous verse, ya ikhwan. So believe in Allah and in His Messenger, the Prophet, al-ummiyyi, the literate one, there's that description again. The literate one, who believes in Allah and in His Word. So follow him and you will be guided.
The illiterate one, right?
The illiterate.
Yeah. It sounds like it says literate.
Illiterate. الَّذِي لَا يَتَكَلَّمْ وَالَّذِي لَا يَكْتُبْ وَلَا يَقْرَى. Meaning the one who does not read or write.
Right.
هَلْ هَذَا بِمَعْنَى أَنَّهُ لَا يَعْلَمُ كَيْفَ أَنْ يَكْتُبَ أَيَّ حَرْفٍ مَا أَوْ بَعْضَ الْحُرُوفِ. When you say someone is illiterate, they can't read or write, does it mean they can't read or write anything? Or generally, they can't read and write? What does it mean? In Islam, when you say, this one is ummi, she's ummiya, she's illiterate, she can't read and write. Do you understand from that, Islamically, that she can't read anything? She can't write anything? Or some things she can write, most things she can't write? What about those small little words?
Maybe most things you can.
Some things, it's not a condition, ya Juan, just because you're illiterate, you can't write alif. You might not can read, or you might can read bad. But generally, they don't have the ability to read and write, generally. But it doesn't mean you can't read anything. Doesn't mean you can't write anything. Doesn't mean that, ya Juan. فَبَيَّنَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي هَذِي الْآيَةِ أَنَّ مَنْ يَتَبِعُ النَّبِيَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ هَدَاهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. So Allah Ta'ala in this verse clarifies for us that whoever follows His Prophet is guided. أَنَّ اِتِبَاعَ النَّبِيِّ يُؤَدِّي إِلَىٰ هِدَايَةِ اللَّهِ. That following the Prophet leads to guidance. فَمَا هُوَ الْمَفْهُومُ لِهَذِي الْآيَةِ. So what's the mafhum of this part of the verse? If I'm saying, from here, Allah is showing that whoever follows the Prophet will be guided. What's the opposite? What's the mafhum? What's the opposite of what's understood? Abdu'l-Bah.
When he doesn't follow the Prophet, we misguided.
Yeah, sense. That's called the mafhum. The mafhum, the opposite of the mafhum. If Allah Ta'ala says such and such, the understanding of the opposite also holds weight. When Allah Ta'ala says in the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam says an authentic hadith narrated by Ibn Abbas and Abu Hurairah and Muawiyah, he says, "Man yuridillahu bi khayra yufaqihu fi deen." He says, whoever Allah intends good for, he gives him understanding of the deen. قال ابن تيمية وابن قيم وغيرهما من أهل العلم. Ibn Taymiyyah said, and Ibn Qayyim said, and other than them from the scholars, وَلَعَكْسُ كَذَلِكَ. And the opposite is holds weight too. If the Prophet is saying, whoever Allah intends good for, he gives him an understanding of the deen, then whoever Allah does not give an understanding of the deen, he does not intend good for. That's called the opposite of the مفهوم. طيب. قال الإمام السعدي فآمنوا بالله ورسوله النبي الأمي. السعدي says, so believe in Allah and His Messenger, the Prophet, the illiterate. السعدي says, إيمانا في القلب. He says, believe where? Believe that is in the heart. Believe that is in the heart. متضمنا للأعمال القلوب. He says, the belief that's in the heart, so much so that it also includes the actions of the limbs, the actions of the heart, wal jawarih, and also the actions of the limbs. Alladhi yu'minu billahi wa kalimatih, and he is the one who believes in Allah and His word. Qala sa'adi, ay amanu or aminu bi hadha ar-rasuli al-mustaqimi fi iqadat fi aqaidihi wa a'malihi. He says, meaning, believe in this messenger, al-mustaqim, who is noble and upright. Believe in him and also believe in his belief and follow him and his actions. وَاتَّبِعُوهُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ, and follow him and you will be guided. قال السعدي في مصالحكم الدنيوية والدينية فإنكم إذا لم تتبعوه ضللتم ضلالا بعيدا. As-Sa'di says, meaning that you follow him in that which will bring you goodness in your religion and in your hereafter. He says, for indeed if you do not follow him, as we just mentioned, as Abdu'l-Ba'an mentioned, then you would have went far astray. If you don't follow the Prophet, you would have went far astray. قال الإمام الوصابي الشرط الرابع. The author continues, condition number 4. من شروط شهادة أن محمد رسول الله. Condition number 4. From the conditions of our bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. قال تصديقه فيما أخبر. الله أكبر. He says that you believe in him in everything that he informs you with. Ain't نحن من هذا. Where are we from that, يا إخوان? بعضنا نرد الأحاديث بدون سبب إسلامي لا نريد أن نقبله فنرد. Many of us, we just reject hadith for no reason. I don't follow that. No, we don't believe. I don't believe he said that. لا يا أخي. هل هو صحيح? Is it authentic? إذا جوابك يكون نعم. فَيَجِبُ عَلَيْنَا نَتَبِعَ. If you say yes, then we're binded. It's upon us to follow it. أَحَبَّهُ مَنْ حَبَّهُ وَكَرِهُ مَنْ كَرِهُ. Like it, who likes it. Hate it, who hate it. إِذَا هَذَا الْحَدِيدُ صَحِيحٌ فَيَجِبُ عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ وَمُسْلِمَةٍ أَنْ يَتَبِعُهُ. أَنْ يَتَبِعُهُ. If it's obligatory, if the hadith is authentic, then it's obligatory upon every male Muslim from mankind and every female Muslim from mankind, and every male Muslim from the jinn, and every female Muslim from the jinn, to also follow this hadith. You just can't say, ya ikhwan, no, I don't take that. La, it's not Christianity, it's not the Jews. La, this is al-Islam. إذا جاءك الله تعالى بآية يجب علينا أن نقبله أن نقبلها. If Allah Ta'ala comes with a verse in the Quran, it's compulsory upon the Muslim to take. إذا جاء حديث صحيح من النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام وهو ليس ضعيفا على المسلم أن يتبعه. So the Messenger of Allah comes with authentic hadith. It's not weak, authentic hadith, and it's compulsory, obligatory upon the Muslim to follow it. قال الإمام تصديقه فيما أخبر به. He says condition number four, that you believe in him regarding what he informs you of من أمرٍ, from those commandments ونهيٍ, and those prohibitions وغيوبٍ ماضيةٍ, and those past affairs ومستقبلةٍ, and that which is going to come in the future وغير ذلك, and other than that. That you believe in him and that which he informs you of, from the commandments and the prohibitions and those unknown, the hidden affairs of the past and that which is going to come in the future, and other than that. نصدقه في كل هذا يا إخوان. We believe in him in all of these affairs. كيف العبد يقول أنا تبع النبي ولكن لا أصدقه؟ هذا لا يعقل أبداً. How is it that a person can say, I follow the prophet, but I don't believe in what he said? I'm not taking his hadith. And what do you believe in? I follow him. He's a prophet. He's a messenger. But I don't take hadith. What's the point? Why didn't Allah Ta'ala just send down the book? What's the benefit of Allah sending prophets and messengers if we don't have to follow them? That's your mind that doesn't, it's not in harmonization with your mind. No. قال الإمام وقال الله تعالى, as Allah Ta'ala says, and Allah Ta'ala, he says, and whatever the messenger gives you, then take it. And whatever he forbids you from, فانتهوا, then stay away. Surah Al-Hashr. فهذه الآية يا إخوان مبينة أنه على المسلم جميعا أن يتبعوا سنة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. So this ayah is a clear proof that it's upon the Muslims to follow the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام. وما آتاكم الرسول, number 7, وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه, and whatever the Messenger gives you, فخذوه, then take it. وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا, and whatever he forbids you from, stay away. وقال عن أبي سعيد الخدري, انظر إلى هذا الحديث يا إخوان. Look at this tremendous hadith. And narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said that the Messenger of Allah said, ألا تأمنوني وأنا أمين من في السماء. الله أكبر. يأتني خبر السماء صباحا ومساء. أخرجه البخاري ومسلم رحمهم الله تعالى. انظر إلى هذا الحديث العظيم. Look at this tremendous hadith, إخوان. The Messenger of Allah said, ألا تأمنوني, do you not feel safe with me? ألا تأمنوني, do you not feel secure? Do you not feel safe with me? وأنا أمين من في السماء, and I am the trustworthy one of he who is in the heavens or above the heavens. يأتني خبر السماء مساء وصباحا, when indeed the information of the heavens come to me, the prophet, مساء, in the evening, وصباحا, and in the morning. حديث عظيم, tremendous حديث يا إخوان. وهذا رد على من يقول أن الله تعالى في كل مكان. And this is a refutation, a strong argument against those that say, no, Allah is not above. You can't say Allah's up. You can't say that. Allah's everywhere. طيب, هذا قول النبي. This is a statement of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. واكتبوا رقم هذا الحديث يا إخوان, and write down the number of this hadith, inshallah. وهو عند البخاري, in Bukhari's narration, 4,094. In Bukhari. 4,000. You brothers online, write this hadith number down. In Bukhari, 4,094. وعند مسلم, 1,064. In Muslim's hadith, 1,064. Bukhari, 4,094. Muslim, 1,064. Do you not feel safe with me? ألا تأمنوني؟ الله أكبر. Do you not feel secure with me, safe with me? وأنا أمين من في السماء. When I am the trustworthy one of he who is above the heavens. يأتني خبر السماء صباحا ومساء. When the information, the news of the heavens come to me in the morning and in the evening. قال الإمام, and we'll stop at this point here, يا إخوان. قال الإمام المصنعي حفظه الله. قال الله تعالى عالم الغيب فلا يظهر على غيبه أحدا إلا من ارتضى من رسول سورة الجن. المصنعي, he mentions, as Allah Ta'ala says, and he is the all-knower of that which is unseen. فلا يظهر على غيبه أحدا, and he does not make known from that which is unseen anyone. إلا من ارتضى من رسول, except whomsoever he wishes to make it known to from the messengers. سورة الجن. قال الإمام أي يطلع الله تعالى رسوله على أمور غيبية. He says, meaning that Allah Ta'ala allows for the Prophet to know some of the affairs of that which is from the unknown, the غيبية, the affairs that are not seen. لتكون آية على نبوته. And Allah does this so it can be a proof of the truthfulness of him being a prophet. وصدقه, and that what he's saying is the truth. وعلى المؤمن أن يصدق بما أخبر به. صلى الله عليه وسلم. And it's upon the believer to believe in everything that the Prophet of Allah informs us, informs the believers, that's going to take place. سواء كان من علم الغيب. And it's the same if the Prophet is informing us about those things that are unknown, or those things that are unseen or not seen. أو كان من الأوامر والنواهي. And it's the same if he's commanding you with something or he's prohibiting you with something. إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. As Allah Ta'ala says, as it comes in Surah An-Najm, verily that which has been sent down upon him is merely revelation. علمه شديد القوى, that the one who has strength, he is the one that taught him. ومن لم يصدق بذلك أو بعضه فهو كافر. And whoever does not believe in what the Prophet informs him of, from the affairs that are unseen or not seen, and from the affairs of the commandments and prohibitions, then this, or some of it, then this one is a disbeliever. If the person disbelieves in all of it, or some of it, the hadith is authentic. The Prophet said this happened. The Prophet said this is going to happen. And a person says, "أنا لا أصدق النبي من أعوذ بالله." And this person says, "I don't believe him." That's how we're doing. We disregard the authentic hadith. What we're saying is, "I don't believe he said it." Because if you believe he said it, there's no way نرده, that we can repel it. We can turn away from it. So we say it, "Nah, I don't follow that." No, you don't have the choice. If it's authentic, ya akhi, you have to follow it. As these ayat show. Allah doesn't say follow it, if you will. Like if you're a Muslim, you're trying to follow the sunnah of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, then you follow his sunnah. طيب, قال كافر. He says, then this one is a disbeliever. كما قال تعالى عن المشركين. As Allah Ta'ala says about the polytheists. بل هم في شك. But rather, they are in doubt. طيب نكتفي بهذا يا إخوان. We'll stop there.
You say that was in doubt.
Talking about the polytheists. بل هم في شك. But rather they have in their hearts doubt. So Allah is saying here that doubt is not a quality of the believers. You can't have belief in something and doubt it. And you don't have belief in it. Certainty يردو الشك الشك. And certainty opposes doubt. Certainty is a condition of la ilaha illallah. So you can't be certain and doubtful at the same time. You can't be certain he's the Prophet of Allah and then doubt what he's telling you. If it's authentic, alayna nu'mina bih, then we have to believe in it. فَإِذَا يَكُونُ ضَعِيفًا فَهَذَا الْأَمْرُ الْآخَرُ. If it's weak, then that's something else, ya akhwan. طيب فنكتفي بهذا وتوقفنا عند حديث أبي سعيد الخدري. So we stopped at the hadith of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. So the fourth condition was that you believe in everything the Prophet of Allah informs us with or to, from commandments and prohibitions and those past affairs that are from the ghaybiyya, that which is not seen, or that which is going to take place in the future, or other than that. وَسُبْحَانَكَ لَهُمُ وَبِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ. For our brothers and sisters online, we'll stop there inshallah. وَجَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.